Welcome to Digital Electronics Lecture Series. I, Professor Ritesh Dholakia, is going to explain you ASCII code in this session. So first, I'll discuss basics of ASCII code. After that, I'll explain you how different characters are represented by ASCII code. And at the end, I'll explain one example which explains you how digital data is stored in computer with respect to ASCII character. First of all, we should know ASCII code, that is American Standard Code for Information Interchange. So here in computer, there are different 127 characters, which is what we are representing by ASCII code. This ASCII code, that is a 7-bit code, and by using ASCII code, we represent 127 different characters, and that starts from 0 to 126. So ASCII code is American Standard Code for Information Interchange. It is 7 bits code. Total 127 different ASCII characters are there with ASCII code, and it starts from 0 to 126. Now I'll give you some basic cases which is there for ASCII code. Like see, you can go through table of ASCII code even, where you will be finding, see, 35, that is equivalent to hash, then 36, that is equivalent to dollar, then 37, that is equivalent to percentage, then 38, that is equivalent to AND, and after that you'll be finding like 48 to 57, that is there for 0 to 9, means 0 is there for 48, 1 is there for 49, likewise up to 57, 9 character will be represented by 57 ASCII code. And after that, 65 to 90, that we use it for capital A to capital Z, right? Means capital A, that we use it with ASCII code of 65, capital B, that we use it with ASCII code of 66, likewise up to 90, that we have it for capital Z. Then you'll be finding 97 to 122, that is there for small a to small z. So small a, that is there with 97 of ASCII code, small b, that is there with 98 of ASCII code, likewise 122, that is ASCII code of small z, right? And last ASCII code, that is 126 ASCII code, which is there for this symbol, and that is equivalent symbol, right? So see, this is how ASCII codes are there. Practically, if somebody is asking me like, can you remember ASCII code? So I'm saying like, see, I don't remember ASCII code, but this is what I need to remember. Like 0 to 9, that is there for 48 to 57, capital A to capital Z, that is there for 65 to 90, small a to small z, that is there for 97 to 122. And in computer, we store 7-bit ASCII code for each of these ASCII character. Now, I have not written all ASCII characters over here with different code, as it is quite difficult to remember. But here, what I want is like, see, one should know ASCII code is American Standard Code for Information Interchange. It is 7 bits code. Total 127 different characters are represented by ASCII code, and it starts from 0 to 126, means total 127 different characters are there in ASCII code. And here, this is what we need to remember. For 0 to 9, ASCII code is 48 to 57. From 65 to 90, ASCII code is capital A to capital Z, and small a to small z ASCII code is 97 to 122. So you should remember this. And it is important for some competitive examination. That's why I'm saying you should remember this. Now, I'll explain you one example where if binary bits are given to you, then how we can be able to write ASCII character equivalent of that. So first, let me write binary data which is given to us. Now our agenda is to convert this binary data into equivalent ASCII. Then first thing that we need to do is we need to write ASCII as per 7-bit grouping.
So I need to start from right
and I need to make 7-bit group over here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. This is 1 7-bit group. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. See, this is another 7-bit group. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. This is another 7-bit group. So as ASCII character that is of 7-bit group, I need to make it with 7-bit group. Now, all I need to do is I need to identify equivalent value of this binary 7-bit. So that one can be able to calculate as per, see, 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32 and 64. And just add it with respect to 1, right? So 64 plus 32, that is 96, plus this 111 means 7. So 96 plus 7, so that has to be 103. So this is what 103 ASCII code, right? Later on I'll explain how to identify this. Now you see, this is 64 and this is 111 means 7. So 64 plus 7, that is 71. So this is 71. And over here, you can see, this is 64 plus this is 13. So 64 plus 13, that is 77. Right. So this is equivalent of 77. And I think you know even how to identify binary to decimal value, right? So these are the binary to decimal values. Now over here, we should know what is ASCII character of this. So see, 103. So if you observe small a to small z, that is ranging from 97 to 122. So over here on my finger, I'll start from 97 and I'll stop it at 103. So 97, 98, 99, 100, 1, 2, 3, right? So I need to start from small a. So small a, b, c, d, e, f, g. So this is small g over here, right? Now 71. So that is there in between capital A to capital Z, you can see. So 71, where we need to stop, right? We should start from 65. So 65, 66, 67, 68, 69, 70, 71. So here, so A, B, C, D, E, F, G. So this is capital G over here. Right. Now for 77, even we need to identify. So 77, we should start from 65. Right. So 65, 66, 67, 68, 69, 70, 71, 72, 73, 74, 75, 76, and 77. Right. So A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M. So this is M. So here we can say this is capital M. This equivalent is capital M, capital G and small g. So that is how we can identify character from given binary data. And this type of questions that I have seen in IAS examination, right? So in tough examination, you will be finding this kind of questions are coming. There can be another type of question, like see, if you have been given with, now question is to write ASCII code for this, right? So here one should know capital B. So capital B, that is there in this range where 66, that has to be capital B. So 66, that I need to write, right? So 66 means this is 7-bit code, right, for capital B. So first bit, that is 1, so that is 64. Then second bit, that is 1, so that will make 64 plus 2, 66, and other bits are 0. So this is what 66, right? Now small c, so that is what A, B, C over here in this range. So 97, 98, 99, right? This was 66, now I need to write 99. And 99, that I can have it by, see, 64 plus 32. So that is 96. So first I need to write 2 ones. So that is 96. And now 3 is required, right? So last 2, that will set to 1. So this will be 3 plus 96, 99. And here 3 zeros will be there. So this is what 99. Now 4, so that is there in between 48 to 57. So 48 is 0. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. 48, 49, 50, 51, 52. So 52 is equivalent of 4. Now 52, that I need to calculate. So 64 is 0. Then 32 will get set to 1. Another 1, that will be 16. So 16 plus 32, that is 48. And now there is a need of 4. So this will be 0 and then 1, then double 0. So this is 52, you can see. So that is how we can translate given character into ASCII, you can see. So this is even a way to have a translation. I hope that you have understood this. Now here I am giving you one homework question. So just write your answers in comment so that I can understand whether you have understood those things which I am explaining over here or not. Right. So I am writing question. So here you can see two questions which I have given. One is binary sequence that we need to translate into ASCII. Right, and second is ASCII series is given, capital B, small b, 48. We need to translate that into binary code. So I hope that you will be writing these answers in comment, and based on that I can get, like, see, you understood this session or not. So please write your answers in comment. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please do give your valuable suggestions. Definitely, based on your suggestions, in future I'll make videos which will resolve your queries. So please give your suggestions here. Thank you so much.